with hair cut square and his eyes alert. He'd stand out in any crowd. I thought how many men like him had fallen through the years. How many died on foreign soil? How many mothers' tears? How many pilots' planes shot down? How many died at sea? How many foxholes were soldiers' graves? No, freedom is not free. I heard the sound of taps one night when everything was still. I listened to the bugler play and I felt a sudden chill. I wondered just how many times that taps meant amen when a flag had draped a coffin of a brother or a friend. I thought of all the children, of the mothers and the wives, of fathers, sons, and husbands with interrupted lives. I thought about a graveyard at the bottom of the sea, of unmarked graves in Arlington. No, freedom is not free.
We heard in the video that when they explained about what the flag was, that our flag is a standard. It's Old Glory. It's a symbol of freedom that waves across the land, and wherever it waves, there is respect because of the loyalty of the citizens of America. Because we know that the price that was paid by the loyalty of some of these people, Danny Danielson is now going to come up and he is going to recite for us the Ragged Old Flag.
This is put together a few years ago by Johnny Cash, and I think he did a good job of telling us about the flag and what it's been through. It goes something like this. I walked through a county courthouse square, and on a park bench, an old man was sitting there. I said, your old courthouse is kind of run down. He said, nah, it'll do for our little town. I said, your old flagpole's kind of leaned a little bit. That's a ragged old flag you got hanging on it. He said, have a seat. I sat down. He said, is this the first time you come to our little town? I said, I think it is. He said, I don't like to brag, but we're kind of proud of that ragged old flag. You see, we got a little rip in that flag there. Washington took it across the Delaware. And it got powder burned the night that Francis Scott Key set up watching and writing a say, can you see? And it got a big rip in New Orleans, Peckham and Jackson tugging at the seams. And it almost fell at the Alamo beside the Texas flag, but she waved on though. She got cut with a sword at Chancellorsville. She got cut again at Shiloh Hill. There was Robert E. Lee, Beauregard, and Bragg, and the south wind blew hard on that ragged old flag. On Flanders Field in World War I, she took a bad hit from a Bertha gun. She turned blood red in World War II. She hung limp and low by the time that one was through. She was in Korea and Vietnam. She went where she was sent by her Uncle Sam. She waved some our ships atop the briny foam. And now we've about quit waving her back here at home. And in her own good land here, she's been abused. She's been burned, dishonored, denied, refused. And the very government for which she stands is scandalized throughout the land. But she's getting threadbare, and she's wearing kind of thin. She's in good shape for the shape she's in. Because she's been through the fire before, and I believe she could take a whole lot more. So we raise her up every morning, and we bring her down slowly every night. We don't let her touch the ground, and we fold her up second thought, I guess I do like to brag, because I'm mighty proud of that ragged old flag. Thank you.
Poetry, because it says that no matter all that it's been through, and it seems like we're in pretty tough times, that ragged old flag sure looks pretty good to me. And because of the fact that the state of our union, I really believe that this next song is so appropriate. It's going to be sung by Betty Rydell, and it's God Bless America Again.
God bless America again. You see all the troubles that we're in. Oh, wash her pretty face, dry her eyes, and then God again. Oh God, could you please bless America again? Just like you did way back when. I know you blessed us then, but we just kind of forgot, and we never asked again. But in these very troubled times, with wars, terrorists, so many people turning evil, God, could you please hold our hand? And if we stumble, please don't let us fall. Oh, God bless America again. Oh, you see all she's in. Oh, wash her tender face and dry her eyes again. God bless America again. Sing it with me if you know the words. God bless America again. Please wash our pretty face and dry our eyes again. Oh, God bless America again. Oh, yes, God bless America again. Again and again.
America again. The next piece is describing what a veteran is. It's called I Am a Veteran. You may not know me the first time we meet. I'm just another you that you see on the street. But I am the reason you walk and breathe free. I am the reason for your liberty. I am a veteran. I work in the local factory all day. I own the restaurant just down the way. I sell your insurance. I start your IV. I've got the best looking grandkids that you'll ever see. I'm your grocer, your banker, your child school teacher. I'm your plumber, your barber, your family's preacher. But there's a part of me you don't know very well. Just listen a moment. I have a story to tell. I am a veteran. I joined the service while still in my teens. I traded my prom clothes for camouflage greens. I'm not the first in my family to do something like this. I followed my father like he followed his. Defying my fears and hiding my doubt, I married my sweetheart before I shipped out. I missed Christmas, then Easter, the birth of my son, but I knew I was doing what had to be done. I served on the battlefront, I served on the base. I bound up the wounded and begged for God's grace. I gave orders to fire, I followed commands. I marched into conflict in far distant lands. In the jungle, the desert, on mountains and shores, in bunkers and tents, on dank earthen floors. While I fought on the ground, in the air, on the sea, my family and friends were home praying for me. For the land of the free and the home of the brave, I faced my demons in foxholes and caves. Then one dreaded day, without drummer or fife, I lost my arm, but my buddy lost his life. I came home and moved on, but forever was changed. The perils of war in my memory remain. I don't really say much. I don't feel like I can. But I left home a child and came home a man. There are thousands like me, thousands more who are gone. But their legacy lives as time marches on. White crosses in rows and names carved in hue, reminding us of what these brave souls had to do. I'm part of a fellowship, a strong, mighty band of each man and each woman who has served this great land. And when old glory waves, I stand proud, I stand tall. I help keep her flying over you, over all. I am a veteran. Measure in our minds and our hearts the prices that were paid for our freedom. And here comes the very next part of the program, which is actually my very favorite. They were going to take and play the branches of the service song, and as they played each service song, if you served in the Army, I want you to stand during the Army song. And if you served in the Marines, I want you to stand when they play the Marine song. And Air Force song, Coast Guard, Navy. So they will announce which brand of service they are talking about. But if you would do that, we would appreciate it. And then after your song is played, you can sit back down. But we'd like to honor those people that took and spent time for us in the military.
Army, first we fight for the right and to build the nation's might, and the army will grow in our lives. Proud of all we have done, fighting middle battle won, and the army will grow in our lives. Then it's high, high day, the army's on its way. Now on the game, try to draw 1, 2, 4, here we go. You will always know that the army's on going along. Marines, from the halls of Montezuma to the shores of St. Paul, we fight out the
Thank you.
As we think of those who did get to come marching home again, we are reminded also of those who did not come home, those that made the ultimate sacrifice. And it causes us to think of the melody Taps. And Taps is a simple 150-year-old melody made up of only 24 notes. When it was written, it was a signal to soldiers for lights out. Today, Taps honors the men and women who have laid down their lives and paid the ultimate sacrifice for the cause of freedom. It can express our gratitude when words fail. There is probably no other melody that can stir our emotions so deeply as Taps. The sounding of Taps is the most sacred duty of a bugler that a bugler can perform. Now, if you would please rise, we'll take this time to quietly pay our respects to those who gave their lives as we listen to the playing of Taps. It is good to remember the flag doesn't wave because the wind blows. It waves with the last breath of every military member who died protecting it. Please be seated. And as we think about the sacrifices that were made, the lives that were given, there were mothers and there were fathers, and there were brothers, and there were sisters, and there were children who no longer had that person in their lives. And even though they have been taken out, the memory still remains. And that it must be a terrible thought to know that your loved one has gone. We're going to have a duet with Elaine Behrens and Jeremy Figa. They're going to be doing the song More Than a Name on a Wall.
Thank you. free.
Thank you.
America, because I think this is the one thing that's going to keep our nation in this perilous time.
Thank you.